Welcome back, everybody. My name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. Today, we are going to talk about Google extensions, how to manage them and remove them. I've done a video previously on what they are and where to find them. So today, we're going to talk about how to manage and remove them. So once you have Google Chrome extensions installed, they're going to show up here right next to your profile account here. You'll see I have a Spotify one, I have a Session Buddy, I have a Google Meet, Grid View, Grammarly, and some other extensions that are not turned on right now. What Google has done recently, within the past year or so, if they've given you this extensions management button. This allows you to manage your extensions with a click of a button in a drop-down menu. And so what you'll see here is you'll see any of the extensions that I have installed that have a blue pin are pinned up here. If I unpin those, you'll notice that those disappear. Now, the reason that I like to use this is because there are times when I am not using a particular extension. So for example, when I'm at school and I'm doing work and I'm working with students or I'm working with teachers or parents, I'm not gonna spend a lot of time on Pinterest. If I'm at home on the weekend, at nighttime, I'm looking for ideas, I'm looking for maybe lesson plans or PD sessions that we can have with our teachers, I'm looking at, you know, behavior plans for our students, this is something that I would then turn back on. When I find stuff, I can pin those things to my board. So the ones that I use the most are Session Buddy, Screencastify, Grammarly, and GridView. So I leave those on constantly. You'll notice here next to the little pin, I have three dots. This allows me to remove it from Chrome, again, pin it. It tells me the options that I have with this individual extension. So when I click on that, you'll see that I have this option, and these are all the options that just come with that specific extension. So this is the Duelist options. If I go to Emoji Keyboard and I click on Options, you'll notice their options are set up a little bit differently. So each extension that you install has a different set of options. Now, some people don't necessarily like this. They like a kind of a board view, and Google has done that for you as well. So when you click on Manage Extensions, what this will do is this will bring up all the extensions that I currently have connected with this individual Gmail account. And this is synced across all of my devices. Extensions do not work on mobile devices or iPads. And so you can see that I have the Chrome apps that I have that are connected. So when I log on another computer under this account, which is my school account, all of these extensions will try to sync at that time. Sometimes it takes a few minutes depending on when the last time that you logged into that computer was, but all of these will sync. So you'll see here, I have the same options that I did in our little puzzle piece dropdown, but I have a few more details. So Bitly, right, it shortens links for me. This is turned off. I can turn it on here. I can actually remove this, and you'll see it's gonna ask me, are you sure you want to report this or remove this? If I click remove, right, it'll say yes, and I'll remove it. It'll give me details about the individual extension, when it was updated, what version we're on, what it can actually, what I'm allowing it to do in Chrome. So I'm here, and let's just Duelist. If I want to remove Duelist, I can click on remove right here. I can click remove over here. And you'll notice now that Duelist is gone. And Duelist is basically a extension that splits the screen. So I'm going to reinstall it here. I use this quite a bit. We're going to add it to Chrome. You'll notice that it's been added to Chrome, but it's not been pinned. So when I pin it, there it'll show up. Again, I can remove it here as well. If I wanted to remove from Chrome, I would click there. It's going to be a double delete or a double remove, and I can click on remove. So those are quick and easy steps on how to remove and manage your Google extensions. If you're a teacher, I want to tell you how much I love you, I appreciate you, and I am glad that you're here.